sun went down and the jungle fire was burning. Down the track came a hobo hiking, and he said, "Boys, I'm not turning. I'm headed for a land that's far away, beside the crystal fountains. So come with me, we'll go and see the big rock candy mountains."
Suspect number one, Kellen Samlowski. He was found the other night after escaping the psych ward, and he has an interesting record for someone who has schizophrenia. To get the best answers, Miami PD decided to send one of our best detectives down to interrogate him.
Hello, detective.
Kellen. Well, let's cut to the chase. I don't care how you got out or why. All I need to know is why.
The rats.
Pardon?
The rats saved me.
Look, I need to know why you're at the...
They said I was crazy.
Was there a murder, Cindy?
Why are you here?
The rats told me where to go. I simply went.
Man, tell me why you were sleeping outside!
They like the fresh air.
Did you kill Richard Palmer?
I don't know if I can kill anyone situated like this.
Suspect number two, the bartender, David Lau. Palmer spent most of his day here before his death. When asked by Miami PD, the bartender was very quick to key us in about every detail that happened that evening.
Drink, please.
Coming right up.
Thanks for the service.
Having a rough day? So, where are you from?
New York.
You like it up there?
Hey, it made me money, that's enough. You know, I always wanted to be a dancer. They said I had the moves in high school.
Well, for what it's worth, this wasn't my first option either.
Hey, I'll go back to my place.
Forgot your keys.
Thanks. Hey, baby, come back to my place later.
Suspect number three, the mobster, Francesco Tamborelli. He's got quite a history with the police, and the Miami Police Department has determined that this is no good if he's involved.
Mr. Tamborelli.
Detective, what brings you down here this time?
I could ask you the same. Are you familiar with Richard Palmer?
The pinball guy? Never met him.
What brings you to Miami?
Need to blow off some steam. Richie got taken in for one of your battery charges.
Would you care to explain as to why we found one of your little cards in Mr. Palmer's wallet?
Not the faintest idea.
Look, he's currently involved in a murder case. Pretty gruesome.
They killed Palmer? Am I under arrest, detective? I've got to go tell.
We know about the laundering. Were you here to meet Palmer?
The ban up in New York's been hitting us pretty hard. Palmer shut down his factories, came down here almost immediately.
That doesn't answer my question. Why are you here?
I needed to talk to him about some business, but I promise you I never even considered hurting him. He's too good to us.
Thank you for your assistance. See you back up in New York.
Extra questioning. Mr. Tamborelli did mention a tall man following him around. He doesn't match one of the suspect profiles, though. Suspect number 4, the receptionist. She was pretty tricky. I guess she's not a big fan of law enforcement. Outside of answering her crossword puzzle, she gave up some fairly decent information. Palmer had paid for his room in large bills, so Miami PD assumes that he brought most of his money with him. She also mentioned a man in a trench coat again. He's a sanitary worker at the hotel. Suspect number 1, Kellen, the insane guy. Suspect number 2, David Lau, the bartender. Suspect number 3, Francesco Tamborelli. And suspect number 4, the receptionist. Despite thorough questioning, none of these suspects presented any real motive to kill Mr. Palmer. The department was stumped until one of our detectives came forward with an idea. Mr. Palmer was spotted handing his keys off to a man in a trench coat at the bar. This man was also present when Mr. Palmer checked into the hotel. The man was also spotted following Mr. Tamborelli when he arrived. Though it's a long stretch, the Miami Police Department decided that it was him. This was our guy.
Thanks for the help, Detective.
Hey, man, no problem. On the day's work.
Hey, somebody get him! Stop! Hey,
back here!
Get down!
Hey, get back here!
In the big rock candy mountains, there's a land that's fair and bright, where the handouts grow on bushes and you sleep out every night, where the boxcars all are empty and the sun shines every day on the birds and the bees and the cigarette trees, the lemonade springs.
Did you kill Richard Palmer?
Nuh-uh.